Hello guys and welcome to the Upper Room. My name is Pascal and of course I am your host. On today's episode, we're going to be talking to a friend and a brother, okay, a colleague as well, a musician, okay, a producer, and of course a multi-instrumentalist and a person of Ade Ebenezer, probably known as OLAKIRA. Brother, welcome to the show. Let's get things started real quick. Now, today on the show, we're going to be talking about something really good, okay? This is the Upper Room, where we just talk about how the grace of God has actually blessed us, the things God has done for us, and the moments we feel the power of God in our lives, and of course, how we've been generally moving through life. So I ask you real quick, what major lessons, okay, have you learned so far in your journey about grace, about great thing? What major lesson have you learned?
The major lesson I learned is to, you know, involve God in everything you do.
Involve God in everything. That's like so big.
Mm-hmm. So I was brought up as in a Christian background. I mean, it's a, can I say, deep Christian background? I don't know. Like my siblings, most of my siblings are pastors, and I'm just the one that is not really like. You know what I mean?
You're like that black sheep in the family. Yeah, how's that?
But still, it will reflect definitely in your daily, you know, yeah, your attitude and everything, because you brought up that way. So but at the point I went astray because you know, I was on the street trying to like survive. But you know, when I was lost and I told God that what's wrong, and he said, you are not closer to me. Like you're lost. Like you need to get closer to me more. I'm the key. I'm the way to your success. Right from time, you know, you have there's has been a different vision about you. But why is it not manifesting? You are right. You are not young. You're not getting younger anymore, and still nothing has happened. Then you need to get closer to me. Then I was closer to God. I think at some point, I talked to God like I'm talking to someone. Like there's somebody I'm talking to on my phone, but nobody. But I was talking to him, and I realized he was hearing me. I said, "Baba, lighten this up now. Please help me. You know, like make this thing happen." And
it happens. Like your father, you're talking.
There has to be that
father.
Belief. Yeah. That's really strong.
All right. So OLAKIRA, yeah. Let's talk about your moral values now, as an artist and as an entertainer. Do you think like your moral values still corresponds with the one you had before when you were growing up, from the background, you said that your parents, a lot of them, your siblings, a lot of them are pastors, and do you think your moral values still correspond with that particular?
No, definitely it's good, because you know it's like a good thing. You know, the way you behave then when you're in your teenage, mm-hmm. you can be definitely when you are in your, you know, your adulthood. I've changed, but the only thing is what I learned so far is discipline. Discipline really matters. You have to be disciplined, you have to be, you know, yeah, be able to be, you know what you're doing, you know. Discipline is one of the major key though. That's what has helped me so far. But because definitely this stage I have now, I see like there are many things that's beyond my life, is beyond my like control. Sometimes I see things that I didn't even experience when I was growing up. So but because I learned to discipline myself. There was a time I even fell apart, I won't lie. There was a time I fell apart, I was...
From God entirely.
I was addicted to, you know, some... Yeah, so but I got addicted to something and I couldn't get over it until I was able to, you know, like get back on track. And, you know, thank God I went for therapy and...
No.
These are the things you said, like, you have to, you have to be disciplined, you have to build that mind. Let your mind be strong to control things, to control environment and things around you as well. You get
absolutely.
So, yeah.
Absolutely. All right. So let's talk about grace now. A lot of persons sometimes feel like majority of these artists actually use black powers, as the case may be. Yeah. But we know that, man, there are people that grace works for 100%. And we've seen that in your life. How would you say grace has worked for you?
Yeah, I like the fact that, you know, when you started that conversation, I was like, what are you trying to say? But you said, we know that there are some people that works for.
Yeah.
So, because I wouldn't lie, I've been to a place that when I was trying to, I followed my friend to a place and we went to one herbalist, one baba in one state like that. And the man was really scared. I told him, I said, bro, this place we are, I don't want to stay here, or I'm scared of this place. Like, I only escorted him. I wasn't going up because I don't
believe. Follow and go. You know what I'm saying?
Like, it was like he's scared. And I told him, I said, we should leave this place. And he was like, bro, the herbalist's son said, why are we scared now? There are a lot of artists that come to this place. I thought it was a joke, bro. I don't want to go deep into that.
Mm-hmm.
I was convinced, like, I was like, well, I thought it's talent. I thought it's just talent, basically talent, and just. So that's when I got to realize that, okay, if it's what you believe, you just have to go with what you believe.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe in God. That's why I'm like, okay, yeah, so it's in God I believe in. And that's why I was able to, like, you know,
break free and break through.
Yeah, and just put my hope, everything in God. Anything I do, I put it in God, because, like I said, there has to be a connection between you and him.
Absolutely.
So, yeah.
Guys, it's still the upper room, and of course, we're still enjoying our moments we're here with OLAKIRA. He's telling us a lot of things about himself, of course, about life as well. We're going to go on a short break. When we return, we're going to continue. Stick around. Welcome back, guys. It's still the upper room. We're still here live with OLAKIRA. Now, we're still here and we're still having a great conversation with him. Many people told you that you're a star even before you became a star.
Definitely.
What were the things that you did differently that put you in that light of finally being a star? You know, it's not only about, you have to put work.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, once the prophecy is given, you also have to put work.
Definitely.
So, what were those work?
I was hardworking, honestly. I know the numbers of sleepless nights that I had, and I never knew it was gonna pay. Mm-hmm. I never ever saw it. When everything manifested, I realized that, oh yeah, this is what should happen. Put God first, hard work has to. You have to work hard to achieve that, because it's more like competition.
Absolutely.
So that's, yeah.
Listen, this particular question I want to ask you right now is off the book, but I'm gonna ask it. Mm-hmm. This particular question is, now a lot of persons, or a lot of people, as the case may be, already forgetting the fact that there are powers beyond, okay?
Mm.
And is it that you choose God or you choose gods? You understand?
Yeah, yeah.
But the 21st century youth and the social media age, this social media
Gen Z's,
yeah, as the case may be, they're forgetting the fact that, man, there are powers and people, there are miracles, okay? People can literally be blind and they see. People can literally be lame and they walk. People can literally be having illness in their body. And once the prophet goes, like, man, you're healed.
Mm.
And truly, truly, you become healed. People forget and they just laugh. Though we still have people that, okay, pastors of these days that actually try to fake those things. But
yeah,
you still believe that they're still original ones?
Of course. I'm an example. That's why I beat my chest. Like, I'm an example of that. I think I lost it at some point. You know, sometimes when you're on the street and nothing is working, you'll be like, come on, see, this God ever exists. Like, what's in this upset? You'll be like, say, all these appearance, just they give us formats. You understand? Like, there's no God. Come on, just do your thing. Mm. But, bro, when I started believing that, I lost it. When I came back to God, you know, things started working good for me.
Manifesting speed, yeah.
And I, like I said, there was a time when my song was out there. I said, God, I know this song is already catching vibe, but I want this song to go viral. The next thing, I woke up in the morning, I started seeing people TikTok being around. I said, God, I want Maserati to sign. Yeah. I was just talking to God, like, I would just wake up. This thing is very funny, but it's real. I said, God, I want Maserati to just, God, can you make it happen? The next thing I saw on my DMs, verified Maserati. Yeah. You know, this thing happened. So you have to, like, believe. That was it.
Believe, yeah.
You have to believe in God and just work towards it. have faith and just work towards it.
Absolutely. That's really fantastic. Okay, so Olakira, tell us like five of your favorite quotes. Quotes. Like maybe, without God, you are nothing.
With God, all things are possible. I use that a lot. Yeah. You know, trust in God.
Trust in God.
Yeah. And get closer to God.
Get closer to God, yeah.
Seek God as your father.
Seek God as your father. Yeah. Seek God as your father.
And when you're down, always call on Him. He's there for you.
This one is the Ogapatapata of them all.
No.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Say that again.
When you're down. The only person that can help you is God.
Mm.
I think if that is very deep, it's very simple to. People say it a lot, but it's deep.
Yeah.
To understand. It's very deep.
Exactly. There are going to be times that, man, you're going to feel like everything is over, but only the person that can actually just come through for you. Everybody is gone, but don't worry. God is still around.
So, like, call your friend, call your mother, call your parents. Yeah, you can't.
And even the crazy part is the fact that, man, even sometimes when you feel like everybody's gone and you feel like God has left you, that's when it's by your side.
Honestly.
The most. That's definitely. The truth. So, before I let you. Go ahead.
Call on Him.
Yeah.
He's waiting for you.
Yeah, at that moment, He wants you to open the door for Him. He wants to come in. Okay. So tell us five things you are most grateful for. Five things you're most grateful
for. Yeah, I'm grateful for life.
I'm
grateful for the talent. Mm. I'm grateful for my family, my upbringing. I'm grateful for my, you know, the field I'm into.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm grateful for the fact that, you know, you know, like I'm a child of God.
Very important.
Yeah.
Life, family, where you are, the talent.
Child of God.
Fantastic. Some persons out there that are gonna see this particular chit chat we're having with you here. Something that you say to them may just go a long way to change a lot of things in your life, coming from God to you. So what do you want to say to you? The people watching this at this person moment.
Basically, if you're out there, you're like giving up already, you know, my story is very interesting story. I think I got signed at my early 30s. I don't disclose my age, but yeah. At that point in time, you know, I'm already giving up already. I've not even given up. But just don't give up. Believe in God. Keep walking, trust in God, build friendship with Him. No matter how busy you are, no matter the environment you are, make sure you communicate with God. That matters a lot. It goes a long way. And always let Him know what's up, what you're doing. Like, always talk to Him and just keep walking, believe in yourself. 100, it has to be there. Because nobody will help you, you have to help yourself. Nobody will encourage you. Let me be honest with you. You have to encourage yourself, and with God, all things are possible. Yeah,
with God, all things are possible, and that's how we come to a close of the particular show, The Upper Room, today. Thank you so very much, my brother, for coming through on the show. I appreciate it all the time. Thank you so very much. All right, so we'll see you next time. Make sure you follow us on all our social media platforms that's currently being displayed on your screen at this present moment. My name is Pascal, and till I see you next time, always believe that God is the greatest.